How can we depict a complex number graphically? For the real numbers, we can use the number line, but we have no room for the complex numbers on this line anymore. So how do we solve this? Well, we use two lines, one for the real part and one for the imaginary part, which means that we will get a plane, the complex plane. So how does it look like? Here we have our complex plane C. We have two axes, the real axis where we put the real part of Z, the x-axis and the imaginary axis, and the y-axis where we put the imaginary part of Z, B. And notice that both the real part of Z, A, and the imaginary part of Z, B, those are real numbers. The imaginary part is the part which is in front of the eye. So the imaginary part itself is just a real number. So the point A, B is a point consisting of two numbers, and that is identified with the complex number Z equals A plus BI. So the only I in the picture here is over there, and how you interpret, say, the point in the plane, which is just a normal point. Now you know for points in the plane, you can use the Cartesian coordinates A and B, but you can also use the polar coordinates R and theta, where R is the distance from the origin to the point, and theta is the angle with the positive x-axis, as in the figure. So we can do that for complex numbers as well. We have the same formulas, x or a equals r cosine theta, and b or y equals r sine theta. And this way of viewing a complex number with polar coordinates is called the polar form of a complex number. So how do we compute the r and theta for a complex number? Well, for the norm, the r, we don't have any problems. You just have the r squared equals a squared plus b squared, so r is equals the square root of a squared plus b squared, and you always have the positive square root because the r is a distance. For the other one, the theta, which is called the argument of Z, we have to be a bit more careful. Of course, you know a equals r cosine theta, b equals r sine theta, you can divide, so you can have the tangent of theta equals b over a. Up till now, it's fine. But now, we have to be careful, because if we solve this, we'll find argument theta, but if you go in your figure 2 pi further, you are at the same angle, and 2 pi further, you're again at the same angle. So you have an infinite number of correct arguments for any complex number z. So that's why we call theta the argument of z with small a. Then you can add any number of 2 pi you like. But if you say, well, we want some specific a value of theta, then we use the capital A, the argument of Z, and then we say, well, in that case, the theta has to be between minus pi and pi. So you have to choose that theta such that your theta is between minus pi and pi for the capital A. And if you use the small a over there, you can add factors of 2 pi, as many as you like. Let's do an example, because we will have to be careful on one more point. First, we do the one plus I. And we have a equals 1, b equals 1, so square root of 1 squared plus 1 squared equals 2. So r1 equals square root of 2. That's no problem. Now we have to be a bit careful. The tangent of theta 1 equals 1 over 1 equals 1. So what do we find? If you would just plug in on your calculator, theta 1 equals pi over 4. And in this case, well, that happens to be the correct one. But we have to be a bit careful, because if you solve tangent of theta equals 1, you get theta equals pi over 4 plus any multiple of pi. You can add any factors of pi. Well, if you would add 2 pi, you still have a correct value of theta. But if you would add only pi, then you don't have a correct value of theta anymore. So when solving here, you have to be a bit careful. Solving tangent of theta equals some number yields you two values for theta up to factors of 2 pi. And how do you find the correct one? Well, you have to look in the figure. 1 plus I is in the first quadrant, so you need to pick the angle pi over 4, because picking minus 3 pi over 4, would then you would be in the third quadrant. So the small argument of Z1 equals pi over 4 plus any multiple of 2 pi. You can still add factors of 2 pi, of course, then you're back at the same value. And capital argument, that one is uniquely defined, equals pi over 4, because that one has to be between minus pi and pi. And you'll see the problem if you go to Z2 equals minus 1 minus I. a2 minus 1, b2 minus 1. So the norm is the same as the previous one, square root of 2. And the equation for the tangent of theta 2 is also the same, because tangent theta 2 equals minus 1 over minus 1 equals 1 again. So your solution equals again pi over 4 plus k times pi. And if you just plug it in blindly in your calculator, you only find the pi over 4, which gives you the incorrect argument, because you have to add a multiple of pi. So that means you can get either pi over 4 or minus 3 pi over 4 up to a factor of 2 pi. And now your minus 1 minus I, that one is in your third quadrant, which means that in this case your theta equals minus 3 pi over 4. So your small argument equals minus 3 pi over 4 up to a factor of 2 pi, and the principal value of the argument equals minus 3 pi over 4. So with the argument of a complex number, you really have to be aware that you have to be careful. First of all, you can add factors of 2 pi, which is taken care of by the small a and the capital A. And second of all, you have to be careful. Your calculator only gives one answer, but if you draw your complex number in the plane, you will always be able to find the correct answer of the two.